Well, that concludes the treatment process for this case. The patient was very happy with the new restorations, even commenting that the results exceeded her expectations. Where I'll take you through the final delivery of the BruxZir Esthetic crowns on tooth numbers 7 and 10. To expose a bit more of the prep and protect the sulcus from excess cement, I pack a size 000 cord around both 7 and 10. If placing cord before cementation, ensure it's packed deep enough beyond the margins. Otherwise, cord getting trapped under your restorations would be a very bad day at the office. We clean the restorations out with Ivoclean to remove any salivary phosphate contaminants that can interfere with the bonding of these restorations. We allow the Ivoclean to interact for at least 20 seconds, then rinse and dry. We then apply a very thin coat of OptiBond Universal inside the restorations to act as a primer for the zirconia. Once the restorations are cleaned and primed, I begin prepping the teeth for bonding. To disinfect the preps, I apply a very thin coat of Gluma, carefully avoiding the soft tissue. Any excess can be removed with a high-speed suction or a dry microbrush. Then OptiBond Universal adhesive is scrubbed on both preps, air thinned and cured. The restorations are loaded with clear Kerr NX3 adhesive resin cement and then seated into place. With a tack cure of about 3 seconds on the facial and lingual, the excess cement enters a gel state for easy removal. After flossing to remove any excess interproximally, we final cure for 20 seconds per surface. Well, that concludes the treatment process for this case. The patient was very happy with the new restorations, even commenting that the results exceeded her expectations. Adjustments to BruxZir Esthetic can be made with a fine grit diamond burr and then polished smooth with a diamond impregnated polishing wheel.